We have been talking about this at our economist events for many years. So it's quite exciting that it's actually happening now. So my first question is for the minister, which is, why did this government choose to go ahead with the project?
I have to say that the Ellinikon project is something that gives pride to any Greek. It is the project that will change the image of Greece anywhere. Because now, the first thing you see when you come and the last thing you see when you go is a place of Attica that is almost a mess. After some years, when the Ellinikon project will be in place, the first thing you will see us coming to Athens with an airplane, and the last thing you will see when you go will be a marvelous place, something like paradise. Something that will really represent how really Greece is. And we're very proud, really proud, that we manage as a government, and if I can speak in a personal basis, I played a role in that, that we managed at the end to reach this point and make it happen. Because a lot of years, many people from the government of Greece, for various governments, had promised that this will start, but at the end it didn't start. With Kyriakos Mitsotakis government, we managed to deliver, and I have to say that I'm really very happy, almost as it's my own property. It's not, unfortunately for me, but I see how well these first 15 days has gone for this project, and from the aspect of sales, and from the aspect of public opinion feelings of this project. Something like the whole Greek people has been engaged in this project now. And I'm very happy about it.
Thank you. So, Odysseus, why did it take so long?
Why it takes so long? There's been a number of reasons. First of all, it's a colossal project. So we have...
Can you hear?
No.
No, microphone not working? Try again.
So, do I continue?
No, no.
No.
Wait, wait.
There must be a technical issue.
They will come to fix
Maybe
it.
Maybe the batteries have gone.
Just a moment.
One moment. I know everybody wants to hear this because we've been waiting. We've been waiting a while.
You see, the problems with the project is all the way. So this is what I had to do.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes.
Is it better?
Yes.
Okay. So yeah, 7 years plus 7 more minutes, right? No, it's been a long way, but and as I said, there is a number of reasons. I think one of them has to do with the project. It's a very complicated one. The other thing is the way that the institutional framework works in Greece. And that's why I think more important than saying why it takes so long is what lessons we got from this and how another one wouldn't take that long and how we can build on Greece's image. I will tell you that when this started, it had been a tough period for Greece. It was the financial crisis, and I remember going to forums around the world and having a bitter taste on what we were hearing about the image of the country. And it became a passion for us to use this project and put Greece on the map for the right reasons, meaning we had to build credibility and we had to create any opportunity for foreign capital to be employed in the country for many. So what changed is that we are seeing a totally different attitude for investments and for the business environment. And this is very, very important. And I'll tell you something. If you look globally, I like to see some examples of nations that have advanced against all odds. And if you look in the last 50 years, you will see Singapore, you will see South Korea, you will see, for example, Israel and Estonia. These are small countries that have done great. And the only thing they have in common is that they opened themselves to the world, they became extrovert to investments, and they were friendly to businesses. And it's very, very important to know that, of course, you will face difficulties, of course, you will face delays, but to know that you can pick up the phone and have a friendly partner in the government and trying to find common solutions is of extreme importance. And this is how we can build credibility as a country and bring more foreign capital to us.
Okay, thank you. So, I guess a big question for both of you, Minister, first of all, and also you, is what benefits is this going to bring to Greece? Now, you said it's a change of image, Minister, but obviously it's much more than that as well. So what benefits will it bring for the economy, for jobs, employment, for society, for people living in Athens and more widely in Greece, and for tourists, presumably,
in
as
under,
well?
The period of the construction, it has been estimated that it will be something like 10,000 new jobs, which is important. When all the project will be in place, the community around the project will be more than 70,000 jobs. But it will change everyday life, I think, of all the people of Athens. Because you see, many people thought that the Ellinikon project would be only a place for the elite, for the very wealthy people, that wouldn't matter for the other people of the city. This is not true. Because Ellinikon project has inside a big park that will be open for everybody. It will have a beachfront more than a kilometer with sunny beach open to society that anybody could reach and go to swim. It will have restaurants, malls, sites for technology, and other good ideas that I don't want to announce here because we have a proper way to announce this decision, but very, I think, wise and good decisions that will make all the society to be implemented in the project. And of course, the people that live near the project, I mean the municipalities around the project, will be really benefit because the values of their property will also go high. And the commerce around with this new society, this Ellinikon project is such a big scale that the truth is it's not just a real estate project. It's a small city in the city of Athens. It's as we have a new Athens in Athens. So, but with the luxury to put everything in place, to schedule it, to know what we won't do. So the people of Athens will benefit themselves from this new region in the Athens. The neighbors of the project will benefit from the rise of the values and all the other things. And the country will be benefited from thousands of jobs, a lot of income, and last but not least, we sold the property for almost €1 billion. This was not money to spare.
Great.
And you want me to add to this?
I do, yes.
If you want me to, because it's difficult to add to what specifically the Minister Adonis Yuriadis is saying, because he covers so well so many topics. But I'll say a couple more things. One is that we're in the era of digital, and we are in the era of green energy. And we believe that Ellinikon can be the ambassador of Greece in climate change. The reason for this is that all the energy that is going to be used is going to be green energy from a renewable source of energy. And it's going to be a from scratch build smart city. Because, you know, you have heard examples around the world of smart cities, but here we have the opportunity to create something totally from scratch on a 100% basis. The other thing that I think the country is going to benefit from is tourism. We have quantity in tourism, but I think this is going to add to the quality and to the duration of tourism and fight the seasonality issue that we kind of suffer from, right? So these are two of the benefits. If you want me to add now to for your international audience and the capital that can be employed, because of the diversity of the project, it's not, as the Minister said, just a real estate project, right? Mm-hmm. We have technology, the smart city element. We have a lot of infrastructure, telecommunication, waste management, water management, and you imagine. So there will be an exchange of know-how also between the foreign companies and the Greek companies and many landmarks. You heard about Foster and Partners, probably, which is the first architect we announced. We have also organized 4 more tenders already. We're going to announce the names in the next coming weeks. So I think this is bringing a lot of visibility to the country.
So there's a lot of interest.
If I can add, and it is a very green project, because this project, British project, covers all the high standards of respecting the environment and the sustainable growth, which is something European Union and Greece want really to implement.
Yes, so you're saying that it's already got some momentum in terms of the interest that it's attracting from investors?
Yeah, actually, we have been, even the more optimists of us, and I was one of them, have been positively surprised by that. There is not only interest and expression of interest, we have real contracts being signed, and we're going to announce data on July 15th, which is what, a week from today to, on a global basis, and I think everybody will be surprised by real deals.
I wanted to ask about what lessons you've learned from this, which are going to be different, I guess, for the minister and for you. You've been engaged in the project for so long. But for the minister, do you think, what are the lessons for you that something like this has finally, you know, come
First
to
of
fruition?
All, I will tell you the lesson as I'm going to explain how we made it happen. When we were elected, the project was almost blocked. So the Prime Minister decided that this is a top priority for his government. And he gave the authority to my ministry and my team to have a supervision of coordinating all the ministries and find ways to go over bureaucracy. We worked very hard, we found a way out. There were a lot of things in front, but we managed to pass them. But after all that has happened, now we are fixing a new legislation for all the big investments in Greece that we put inside all the experience of the problems we had to solve in order to make the Linikon project happen. Because our main idea and our main ambition is that an investor would never need us, that everything would work automatically. Until now, I haven't reached this point, but this is what we want to do. So all the experience of the work we did for this project, exactly because it was a huge scale and almost all kinds of Greek services were interfered, we're putting them in our new law, and I think this will make every investor's life much more easy.
Okay, interesting. And yes, please, view, for you, your lessons are going to be very different, I think.
I'll tell you my view on that. Apparently there are many lessons, but because of time considerations, I will name one or two. One is that, you know, people count in everything, private sector, public sector, but especially in a country, in countries that do not have such a strong institutional framework, it is very important to have a focal coordinator that can solve issues and everything. And I think one of the wise decisions regarding a Linikon that was made 2 years ago by the PM was to have a coordinator. Actually, it was the minister that is sitting next to me. You know, the US has Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos that talk about space trips, and you have Branson, I think. I think we have here the minister of space speed. And this made a difference, this coordination. And also the other thing is that it's been now created, actually last month it was passed by Parliament, to have a central bureau, a one-stop shop for permitting. Mm. And this is not only for a Linikon. I think when the world looks at this process and sees that things accelerate and move fast, they will build more confidence in the credibility of the country that is an intangible asset but has immense value. And I think it's been built month after month in these last 12, 15 months.
I have to send a very clear message to everybody. As a government, we really believe that we have to respect other people's time and money. So we are here to make your life easier. And we can find ways to cooperate with each other and solve the problems that will sure occur, because problems are there, but with the right will and with the right attitude, you can always solve it. And the proof is the Linikon project that I have to say, in the beginning of my term, a lot of people didn't believe that it would really happen. Many of our European partners, when we were saying that we will keep our deal, they were smiling a little bit. And a lot of people betted that at the end we would fail. But here we stand, with a project in progress, with the money in the state, with contract signing, people happy, jobs creating, and as a story of success.
I guess we didn't give up on the project, The Economist, because we did keep inviting you to come to our events and to talk about it, even though in the most difficult times, actually, during the crisis years, when it didn't really seem like a realistic proposition. So I think there's a lesson there also about resilience and belief, I guess, in the integrity of the project and the vision.
Yes, and since you're giving me the opportunity, by the way, this key word, integrity, another thing that this project can prove is that you can do a project in Greece of this magnitude, we're talking about 8 billion euros, and you can do it with the right way and the right integrity. The other thing that you said, about resilience and passion. I think there is a distance between the spot that Greece has in the world and where it could be. And there is a lot of effort recently about bridging this gap, and we want to play a role in helping bridging this gap. Mm. So we have passion about this project.
We're going to wind up, and we've got a very nice segue into our next discussion about business. You know, we save the best till last. You know, the importance, I think, of this discussion is clear to everybody. So I just, as a final thing, obviously the project did have its critics over the years. Are you saying now that it's actually come to fruition? We're not hearing any criticisms, or are there still doubters? And what would you say to them? That's the kind of final
words. The Lincoln project, really. One of the things that I think it's a very good story for Greece, it that unites three different Greek governments with difference between them, especially between Samaras and Tsipras government. Because you see, this project was a vision of Prime Minister Samaras. This is the guy that wanted this to happen and made the tender and signed the first contract. At that time, Syriza, as an opposition party, was fighting the project and had the criticism you mentioned. But then, when Mr. Tsipras was the prime minister, he realized that this is a good project for the country. And then he supported the project. Even now, Syriza in the parliament voted for the project, even though in almost all the other things were against. In the Ellinikon project, we were together. And then Mitsotakis' government came and finished the job and delivered. So I think it's a very good message for the foreign investors of the country that don't know us so well, that even if they hear a lot of noise and quarrels and criticism, at the end, if we have to do a job, we can deliver and find a common way through. I think this is very good for business. So the voice of criticism is not really important anymore.
Mm-hmm. Final word?
Final word, huh? One thing is that it was voted by the parliament with record votes. I don't know if you know about this, but it was 265 out of 300. But this one side, if we go to society now, right, what we see is that 80% of the people not only want the project, big change from 6-7 years ago, mm-hmm. but they are saying, why did it take so long? Mm-hmm. And in order to serve this as Lambda, we have planned, and we already started, very frequent communication. So for all the people, the average people, the people who will benefit from this project, to know what is going on and to express their opinions and to accommodate their opinions in this project. So we want to be very close to society about this and make Greece feel good about it.
Okay, let's hope then that it will be become this flagship project for the government. And I wish it all the success that you wish for it. So thanks very much. Now we're going to broaden out our discussion. The minister's going to stay on the stage with me, but let's say thank you.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, please.